So this is like a boot camp. It's a Bright Focus Alzheimer's disease fast track to allow people to become immersed in not only the information, but also connect with some of their colleagues and with people who are leaders in the field.
I think it's perhaps one of the most innovative programs that any foundation does. We invite the most distinguished, accomplished researchers throughout the world, and they spend 3 days in close proximity with the most junior investigators in the field. It doesn't happen at any other venue that I'm aware of.
You know, foundations like Bright Focus really provide that opportunity to kind of recognize that there's that period that that people really need that bridge, and they provide that. So that's the difference.
And so this conference focuses me on what are the relevant topics today? What are the leaders in the field really excited about today? Where is this field going right now?
Well, that's critical because this is the next generation that will be the scientists of the future.
But if you want to have new scientists, you have to have what I would call it seed money. If you invest in young people, you get benefit later.
We need research to improve society, and we need grants to carry on the research. Without grants, we can do nothing. Funding is very important.
Part of this boot camp, this Alzheimer's fast track, is teaching them how to think of an idea, put it together in a scientific way.
They gave a topic to each group, and each group starts brainstorming and coming up with an idea.
In the format of a grant proposal, they're gonna present it. We're gonna give them 15 minutes to present their idea that they hatched together over the course of this whole meeting.
There are many, many opportunities here that people wouldn't normally get when they're at a big meeting because they don't have that one-on-one time. This really facilitates interactions with the students and the faculty.
Here you go, this is your chance. Go for it. Learn, absorb, integrate everything you can and bring it back to the lab, to other colleagues, and help your career.
That was why I came to Bright Focus. Like, I want to meet with the other folks that are looking at a lot of different avenues where we coalesce on a one kind of idea that may help someone. And not just someone, but a lot of people.
There are great researchers out there who can do great science, but they need funding. And it would be a waste of their intelligence if they can't obtain funding just because they don't know how to write a grant.
Which is really unique and also really useful for students like me who want to one day be in academia and have that research or principal investigator position, is learning how to write grants.
So I applied for funding and was able to be successful in obtaining that. And just from day one of working with them, even like asking them about the application and would I be an appropriate candidate, they've just been incredibly helpful group of people.
So it benefits me in two ways. One is that it stimulates ideas. The second aspect is the people aspect, just meeting people in my position, the other students, meeting the other faculty, being part of a network where we can really help each other.
So we really need foundations like these who have that faith that, you know, let's put in the money in this sort of high-risk research because it can have huge benefit in the end.
Research equals hope. I mean, there's no doubt about it. We're never going to find a cure for any of these diseases other than through research. And these students represent the future of that to ensure that you and I will have a life where Alzheimer's disease is not our reward for living to a long period of time.
And I'm really happy that, you know, I had the chance to experience that.
Bright Focus Foundation. Cure in mind, cure in sight.